Hello students, today we are going to discuss about a very important topic for all of us. Each one of us have one or the other phobia in ourselves. Phobia of water, phobia of height, phobia of darkness. But everyone has a common phobia, that is fear of speaking in front of many people or phobia of facing the audience. Yes. When it comes to speaking in front of many people, we feel shy, we become nervous, and we lose our confidence. Why? Have you ever thought about this? That why we feel so when it comes to speaking in front of the audience? My dear children, today we are going to learn how to be a good speaker in our chapter number 11, Be a Good Speaker, of page number 26 of your Balbharati textbook. Let's see. If we want to share our ideas, thoughts, our concept, or express any view, we have to communicate. Now, communicate, this is a two-way method. It does not mean only speaking. It also means listening. It does not mean only using words or language. It can be with action. It can be with sign language or many ways. But speaking is one of the way to communicate. And this is a very prominent way to communicate and express our ideas very clearly to the person who is listening. Now, when we speak about speaking skill, then we have to speak using a language. Any language. Now, any language has four skills, that is listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Today we are going to focus on speaking. Today we are going to focus on speaking skill. Now, speaking skill consists of four points which we are supposed to mandatorily follow that. Those points are as follows. Number one, to be a good speaker, you have to be very fluent in this or a particular language. For example, you have to pronounce or you have to express those words in that proper manner of the requirement of that language. You must not add any other language accent to that particular language. Number two, you must have a big or a huge vocabulary bank, a good vocabulary bank of that language. Vocabulary bank means you must know more words or many words of that language so that you can share or express your thoughts more effectively with more words so that the audience can understand your thoughts or your speech more easily. Number three is pronunciation. Now, pronunciation must be very clear of any sound of a letter or any word. If your pronunciation is wrong, then your speech will not have that great impact which you wanted to be or you expected. Number four is the pillar of any language, that is grammar. Grammar of any language is very important for speaking or reading or writing anything. If your speech is grammatically incorrect, then you will not get that response from the audience which you have expected. And what you wanted to share to your audience, you will not get it to share in that proper way. Why? Because if your grammar is wrong, you will frame the sentence wrong. If your grammar is wrong, you will not be able to say or whatever information you want to give it effectively or nicely. So all these four points, number one, fluency, then vocabulary, words, word bank of that language. Number three is pronunciation. Number four is grammar. These four things are required to be a good speaker. Now, let's see further what is there in the chapter for us. Now, these four points are used when you are a solo speaker, means you are speaking alone. But what will you do when there are many people with you? Means what will you do when you are a speaker in a huge discussion with many people? Let's see. We all have heard businessmen, artists, scientists, and many other great personalities or role models while speaking. What do? They express their ideas, thought, and shares mostly by speaking, sometimes politely and sometimes firmly. It depends upon the occasion and the audience to which they are sharing their ideas. Same way, children, you have to be a good speaker depending upon the topic of speaking and depending upon your audience. Now, while in discussion method, you have to be very polite and very pleasant. You are not supposed to interrupt in between if there is a discussion going on. That means you have to either use polite words like excuse me, may I, pardon, or just simply raise your hand in that discussion so that you can automatically grab the attention of the other listeners or the other speaker. Next, you have to be very alert while others are speaking. Means, if you want to communicate or in a discussion method, it doesn't mean that you have to only speak. You have to also listen to what others are saying. You also have to give a interest in the thoughts of other people. Means, you have to listen to others, their ideas, their concept, and then you can share with them theirs. And if, for example, you require an explanation or you want to interrupt anyone in between, you have to be very polite and pleasant, and you have to use polite words like excuse me, pardon, may I, or simply raise your hand, as I said earlier. Same way, if you have to be a good speaker, first of all, you have to follow all the four mandatory points. Secondly, in discussion method, you have to be together with everyone. You have to wait for your turn when it comes. Now, when we say use polite words, basically you don't use polite words with your parents, as I'm acknowledged, but you have to change yourself and be polite while speaking with anyone. This means be a good speaker. It doesn't mean in only any official meeting or in any official speech. It means in your day-to-day life, you have to be a very good speaker, polite and soft-spoken, and vigilant and perfect in sharing your perception or your point of view or your ideas to the person who is listening to you. Next. Now, how to prepare a speech? Now, before preparing a speech, you have to write it down. After writing it down, you have to practice it. After practicing it, you have to see whether your rehearsal is appropriate or no, and then you have to present it in front of the audience. This is all mentioned in the textbook. Just go through page number 26 and 27. One more thing I would like to say to everyone, that I want every one of you to participate in elocution competition, which was not done. As I know, all of you are brilliant students. I wanted all of you to participate, but for some reason it hasn't happened. So I'm giving you an activity, and that activity is you have to make a video of about 1 minute of yourself. This is compulsory to everyone. You have to make a video of 1 minute of yourself and post it on your WhatsApp group of your class. Only 1 minute, not more than that. Now, what will be the topic? The topic will be open. You can choose any topic of your choice. For example, any sports player, any electronic gadget, or any actress, or any role model, great personalities, any historical place, or any about space, or anything which you like, or any feedback on the movie which you have seen. But you have to speak for 1 minute with all your confidence, following the 4 points of speaking skills. You have to email me on abbchessclass.05@gmail.com. I will post you the email address on your WhatsApp group, or you post the video on your class WhatsApp group. Anyhow, I will try to provide you a digital certificate of being a good speaker after watching your video. I request all of you to complete the questions of page number 27 in your English notebook, classwork book. Thank you for listening to me and being a good speaker. Bye.